Hey, hello everyone. So in this video I'm going to show you how to construct a class diagram for online train ticket reservation system. So let's get started. So I am going to use star UML. Okay, so after going to star UML, just go to model, okay, and go to add diagram, and you'll be having like class diagram. By default it's class diagram, so if you haven't got any class diagram, just click on this class diagram option over here and you'll be having like all the shapes necessary for a class diagram. So for class diagram, the main thing is the number of classes. Okay, so here I guess we will be using 5 classes. One is for ticket, passenger, and payment, and the train. Okay, details of the train, and final is like the system admin or the train admin. Okay, so these are going to be like our classes. And so let's get started with the first class. Okay, just click on this option, class option, and just press it over here. And our first class, as you can guess, is passenger. Okay, so just rename it to passenger. Okay, so passenger, that's fine, and just make it large. And for passenger, what are details the passenger is going to enter for to book a ticket, okay, in train? So it's going to be name, age, address, and the email ID, phone number, etc. So these are like going to be our default, okay, default attributes. Okay, so just right click it, okay, double click it, and you'll be having like this add attribute. Okay, just select one, and it's going to be like name, and you'll be having name, and the data type of name is string. Okay, string or char, you can put whatever you want. And it's going to be age, it's going to be of type integer. Okay, integer. And next one is going to be date of birth. Date of birth is also of type integer. And next one is email. Okay, email ID, it's of type string. Address, string. I think these are enough. These are like the important things that a passenger has to enter before entering into the system. So the operations what a passenger is going to perform, so it's like the passenger can search for a train, okay, view the schedule, book seats, cancel ticket, and make payment. So these are like the important operations that a passenger can perform. So let's do that. So for that, just double click it, and same thing, you'll be having the next option over here. Like this, it looks like a settings icon. Just select it, you'll be having our operation. So first one is like search train. Okay, search train. And our next operation is going to be book tickets. Okay, book tickets. And select the seats. Okay, both are same, book tickets and select this. So we are like choosing the seat whichever we want. Like we have a window seat, and we have the lower berth, upper berth, like that. So there are like variations in it. And next one is like this one. Okay, edit details. Okay, in case of any change in details of our like name, address, or email ID, we can just change it over here. So edit details, that's also a function. And make payment. Okay, make payment. And cancel tickets, necessary user can do that also. I think these are like perfect for our passenger class, and I think this is enough. At least try to add like 4 to 5 attributes and operations for each class. Okay, that will be really good. And next our class is going to be ticket. Okay, so just select a class and paste it over here and rename it to ticket. Okay, so here we are like what are the details a ticket should contain. Just imagine in the form of a paper ticket. Okay, so we will be having like just duplicate it and go for it. Okay, so we'll be having like the ticket number. Okay, ticket number. So this is going to be of type integer. And our next one is going to be the train name. Okay, that's going to be of type string. And train number, that's going to be of type integer. And next thing is like starting location and the destination. Okay, so it's going to be starting location, which is also is going to be of type string. And destination, destination, and it's also going to be a type string. And also has a custom passenger name. Okay, that's important thing. Like if you are going for like a short term, like in an electric train, means it's just a blank ticket without a passenger in. But if you are going for like a long term journey, at least across cities, it will have definitely have the passenger name and passenger ID. So it's good to include passenger name. So I guess this is enough. Like we are already done 4-5. Okay, how much we run? We run 6 attributes. That's more than enough. That's fair. Okay. And next, what are the information the ticket will contain? Like we have like a cancel ticket, okay, cancel ticket. Yes, like if there's an option for refund for our ticket, that can be done. I think that's what a ticket has. I think it also has like the cost, okay, kind of attribute. Ticket cost of the type integer. Sometimes it may be even a float, okay, so it's your wish, you can add float or integer. So that's fine, we have done with our ticket and our passenger. And our next class is going to be train itself, okay, the entire train. So for that, just rename it to train. So for train, we are just going to have like only attributes. We aren't going to have any operations because it's just a train thing. So only attributes are enough for it. So just double click it and go to add attributes over here. So our first attribute is going to be train number, okay, that's a really important thing, train number. Okay, train number is going to be of type integer. Can't be a float, don't put float there, okay. Train number, it's going to be integer. And train name, like just imagine a type. That's a best way of doing any UML diagram. You need to imagine as if you're doing that particular task itself, and in that way, like you'll be able to get more number of attributes and operations. That's the best way to do. Just personify as if you are doing that particular task. So it's going to be a train name. Train name is going to be of type string. Fine. And next one is the sorting of the source and the destination, okay. So it's going to be same thing as for our ticket itself. It's going to be the starting location, okay, string, and our destination. I guess this is fine. These are details what you have for train, okay. So if you want, you can also add the time, okay, time, the schedule when this train comes, but I think that isn't displayed anywhere, okay, on the train. If you want, you can just add it. You can add the train starting time, arrival time, okay, you can just add that also, no problem. So this is fine for me. So I've run 3 classes, and next one is going to be the backend, okay, the person who controls the backend. It may be like a railway staff, okay. So he's also having like going to have a control over the system. So railway staff. Okay, so I guess like he's also going to have some login, okay, some backend access. So he will also have some login. So basic details, he will have the basic details like email ID, and also add password, okay. That's so common, I am just skipping password over here. So email ID is going to be of type string, and you can also have like mobile number, okay. I've added a phone number here. You can just add a phone number. That's the important thing. Number is also going to be of type integer, okay. Integer, okay, that's fine. And just add it also. So I think the backend staff will have like all the control, because he or she is the person who is going to just maintain all the stuff, okay. Generate that ticket list, okay, ticket list for the TTR to check for each and every passenger who is coming inside the train. So he has like operations like update schedule, okay, when the train is going to arrive and when the train is going to like depart, that stuff. And modify ticket count, okay, which is a really important thing. Modify ticket count. So in case like if the tickets have been completely booked, the passengers should not go and book any extra ticket, okay. It would be like invaluable. So in that case, the railway staff work to inform that the particular train has been fully booked. So it's going to, next is going to be like offers, okay, inform offers, okay. So in case of like any this one special festival time, they will give many offers, okay. New special trains will be announced. So in case of any notifications, it's the duty of the railway staff to send that particular information to our customers. So I think these are more than enough, okay, for our railway staff. Okay, so that's fine, and our final class is going to be payment. Okay, make payment. That's fine, and just logic. So here we'll be having some of the basic attributes. Just imagine, just any payment system, you'll be having the passenger name string, and you will also be having the card type. Okay, card type, credit card or debit card, that's going to be of a type string as well, and card number integer. So I guess these are like my important attributes while making payment. You have the password, the expiry date of the card, you just add it out. Okay, I don't want to waste your time saying that enough. And make payment, that's it. I guess in make payment, we can't cancel ticket while making any payment, so I guess that's enough. So let's just now connect our classes with a data line. So how to connect this all? Okay, so it'll be just this way. Okay, that's fine. And just go for data association, go to passenger to ticket, and we'll also have option for make payment. Okay, train to ticket. Okay, and he will also like have a access for the ticket. Basically, like the passenger will have like access to all the things. Okay, you can also put from passenger to train. Okay, that's not going to be a big fault. So I guess this is fine. Maybe just you can rearrange in a better way. Okay, to avoid that collision. Okay, I hope this is like fine. Okay, and that's it for this video, and I hope you would have found this video useful. And I also learned many class diagrams, attribute diagrams, use case diagrams, so do check their videos. And mine is actually a program channel. I've done tutorials in C, C++, Java, Python, Blender, the distributed animation, Unity. So do check other videos of my channel, subscribe and support me, and thanks for watching.